What's up, guys? Today I'm gonna be working on the Evo. I'm gonna be doing the clutch master cylinder. This is for people that can't do the recall that's supposed to be on it. I was trying to go to the dealership to get it done, but for some reason they wanted to charge me because they're not sure if that's the fucking problem. But anyway, I'm gonna do a video. I'm gonna do it very detailed because this is a 2015 model, and I couldn't find any of them that was for the 2015, so I had to order the 2008 to 2013 model. And with that one, you have to do a few extra bullshit. So like I said, I'm gonna go through what needs to be done. So that way, if you decide to do it, like if your clutch master cylinder just go take a shit and you decide to do it on your own, then I'm gonna have a video so that way that you can see what's going on, and you will understand like exactly how to fucking do it. So let me get into it and I'll get back at you. All right, so first thing that you want to do is take off the strut bar that was on the top here. I already took mine off. And then what you also want to do is you want to remove your air box. You want to get this out of the way. And then if it's easier for you, I don't think I'm going to move this, the ECU. And you got to take off the brake booster and the canister here. So that way, because the clutch master is back there in a tight spot. So basically, move whatever is in your fucking way. Alright, so this is the clutch master cylinder here, official from Mitsubishi Motors. This is everything that comes with it. Cylinder, adapter. Comes with the adapter for this, and here's the plate to lock it in place. Comes with some screws, and these are the screws that go on, screw the master cylinder onto this here. So, and then you have your lines from this to your slave cylinder. Comes with copper washers. These are bolts here and banjo bolts. Create a line so that way. I recommend to change it. I'm pretty sure some people won't, but it's a stronger line, so I would. But yeah, that's all. Also, I recommend getting the OEM one. I got this from Matt Performance. I talked to the guy. Real cool dude. He actually talked me out of getting the aftermarket one. He said that the aftermarket actually fails after a few months. So I got the OEM one. It's a few extra bucks more, but it's worth it at the end. You know, you don't want to pay 200 or something bucks for a aftermarket one, and then next thing you know, a few months later, it takes a shit on you. Then you're gonna be sitting there with a sore ass. So invest in the OEM one. This is from Mitsubishi Motors. Okay, so this is how far I got. Took out the air box, I took off my blow valve. What I forgot to do is, this is the positive. Go and disconnect your battery because you gotta take that off so that way it can be out the way also. So that's what I'm about to do now.
next thing you want to do is take out that bolt on the brake booster. There's one there, then there's one at the bottom right there. Right there. Alright, now with the master cylinder removed, take off the brake booster. You gotta go inside and take out four bolts. I gotta take this off, and I'll show you in a few minutes. Alright, next step you wanna do, see my pedal is all the way to the fucking floor. But next thing you wanna do is on your brake pedal. You have a clip here, you're gonna wanna take that clip off, and then you wanna take these four bolts out. Two there, and two there. Now I took all the screws off the brake booster. I got this line off. You can just put it somewhere over there. And then what you want to do is you're going to want to remove this line and make sure you don't break anything. Like these. You don't want to break these, or you'll be fucked. Pull it out. Okay, so next thing you want to do after you get the brake booster out, you have this big ass hole here. There's your shitty master cylinder. And what I did was, that's here that holds this line on. I took that off. So that way when I go inside, when I take it off, I can just change this out. This line is getting changed anyway to the braided one that was provided with the kit. Yeah. Alright, so a little backtrack. I took, like I said, I had took a clip off of this line here. Next, you're gonna want to take off this clip here. That line runs here. There's one clip here holding on to the line. And then your slave cylinder here, right there. You have a thing there, so you want to loose this, and then that's when you go inside, you loosen all the bolts, and then you just take it out. Alright, so the next thing I'm gonna do is fucking take this shit off. I don't know how to take it off. Okay, so when it comes to the thing, all you gotta do is unclip it, take a small flathead and just pry it out, and it should come off just like that. I couldn't record me doing it, but yeah. You too, bitch. Hold on, I'm trying to record. Why is this shit stuck in here? That's hot. Alright, so next thing you want to do is twist it. I don't know which way you twist this shit.
see something real quick. I gotta take this clip off first.
All right.
Now that's out. I gotta get the other piece out. So I'm a little wet. Probably fell off inside. But should got an O-ring on it. Next step would be to drill out these. I gotta figure out which one to drill out.
Alright, so I got the old one out. There's this junk, it was leaking from here. Oh. Okay, anyway. Then I took the fork off of this, because this is used, I think this is used for the brake booster, because it's the same. Same thing. So now I have this, which goes from here to the
slave cylinder down there. I gotta take that off next, and then I'll update you guys on the hole drilling.
Alright, next up
is to loosen this line here and then take it out completely, because you're not gonna need this no more. But
what up?
We'll save it. Got that. Take this shit out as soon as I get it.
Get it out without breaking anything.
Excuse my assy hands.
Mine is out from the old brake booster. Guess what it looks like. There's a bracket here that you gotta take off. Mine's just loose because I did a clutch on it and never put it back. Thank God. Alright.
I had to take this off so that way I can get to that. And then, let's get to the drilling.
Yeah. Alright, so next move is to swap out that piece for this one. And how this works is, I swear to God, I hit those birds. Okay, so how this works is, this piece goes onto here, and then you have this. This goes like that to hold the ball in so that it don't fall off. But that's till later. Right now I gotta size this up.
Huh?
Alright, next step you wanna do is you wanna take the studs out that came inside of it originally and switch them out for these Allen heads. So that way they face the other way, because the studs poke into the firewall, giving it a little bit of space between it. You don't want that. So now step two, I gotta take off the nuts from the inside
that hold those in, and then grind them out, because you can't hit them out.
They're welded on there, like spot welded. Day two now. It's damn near fucking 35 degrees out, but shit gotta get done.
I ran into this match where I had this facing the other way, where the holes would be like over here somewhere. Make sure you drill out these two tabs, and I'm gonna leave a picture in here. These two tabs, there's one there, and focus. There's one here, and there's one on the other side. Those two tabs are the one you wanna drill out. Not the ones that you see right now, because I fucked up. But I have a machine shop, so I drilled two extra holes in the plate so that way I can just turn it instead of knocking those two out. It was a lot easier doing it that way, and I don't have to worry about structural integrity. So now I got everything tightened. I'm about to put the brake booster back on.
There. Brake booster. Put that shit back on. Then I'll get back to you.
I got the brake booster in. I got one of the lines hooked back up. Got the reservoir in. I gotta put these in. Gotta be careful. Cause I bent them, but not that bad. But I had to get them out the way. But you want to be careful when you handle these, because you don't want to snap them. Put this up. Put that back up. Put this hose back. Once I find it, I don't know where the hose go. Where the fuck did the hose go? That. I'm sorry for my shitty videoing. The hose back on for that.
Go, guys, everything's back together. Washed up all the brake fluid that came off on the car. Cleaned the engine bay a little bit, and it's running. Only problem I have now is that I need to bleed the brakes, and that's it. Car is good. Thanks for watching, and remember to like and subscribe.